So, I got a new car. Got a 2017 Jetta. I've always really liked Jettas. So I was excited to get it. I'm not really a car guy, so buying like super fancy, expensive cars is never something I'm gonna do. I don't drive that much. Like, I work from home. Like, I drive to the gym and back. Like, I don't... And plus, I'm not, like, someone who really, like, gets any type of enjoyment out of, like, a nice car. So, I just like new cars. I like new and reliable. You know, I'm not a car guy in the sense of, like, working on cars either. So, like, going the whole, like, used car route, have it for 10 years is not really something I like to do because, like, I mean, I've had my car for a while, and it's getting a little bit older, and it's getting to the point where things are starting to break down in it, and it's a pain in the ass. So it's time to get something new. I still have my other car too, but this will be the main car now. And you know, for the prices, like a Jettas are like sick cars for the price. Like, you can't really beat them. You know, it's funny. I always laugh at kids who like buy up. Like not, like, cars are never really a good value. Like, let me just say that right now. Cars are never a good value. Especially, like, newer cars are never a good value. But, you get kids who are in their 20s, mid-20s, who buy like, a really fancy car, but then they live at home. It's like, come on. I can't take you serious. You live at home. You're not balling. You just have no responsibilities or no bills. I'm convinced I'll never be as wealthy or as rich as I was when I was in high school. Like, I'm being serious. Just because, like, I worked all the time, and I worked for a contractor and got paid really well for a high school kid. Got paid really well. And, like, I worked 50 hours every week during the summer, worked as much as I could during the school year, especially my senior year of high school. I worked all the time. And, I lived at home, didn't really have any bills, didn't have any responsibilities. Like, I was just banking thousands and thousands of dollars when I was in high school. It actually, part of that allowed me to, when I got to college, eventually allowed me to start Hunt Fitness because I didn't have to work as much, didn't have to make as much money in college because I had so much money saved. But it's all perspective. Basically, what I'm trying to say is when you have no expenses, like, it's easy to seem like you have more money than you actually do. End of rant, end of my welcome to the real world rant. But, all right, I got some running around to do today. I'm gonna go to Chipotle right now. I'm starving. And then I think I'm gonna get my hair cut. And then probably go to the gym. But I got a couple other stops to make, so I'll take you along with me. So I just had my Chipotle. It's been a while since I had Chipotle. Probably a month. I've gone a month since having Chipotle. It was good. However, I was really hungry. Like, I ate it quick. That feeling when you finish your Chipotle and you feel like you could eat another burrito or two. I had that. I've actually ate two burritos one time. It was a long time ago. I ate two fucking Chipotle burritos in one sitting. I've done it before. Doesn't really make you feel the most comfortable. Definitely not something you want to do before you plan on training. I plan on getting my hair cut and then going and work out. I'm actually sitting here kind of debating if I even want to get my hair cut. I always do that. Like, it's right in the same plaza as the Chipotle. So, it's super convenient. I'm right here. I might as well get my hair cut, but I don't know. It's a pain in the ass. Like, I just don't like sitting there and wasting time. But then again, I'm sitting here wasting time talking about it, so I might as well just do it. I like going to Sport Clips because I can sit and watch. At least I can sit and watch SportsCenter while I'm getting my hair cut. And plus, I'm kind of sick of it being long. I want to get it short again, so all right. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna get my hair cut. I'm gonna do it. I'm really gonna do it. All right. The next clip you see, I will have short hair. And there it is. Got my hair cut. Gotta stop at the store, get a drink. Get an energy drink. I'm getting a little tired. Not really tired, just my afternoon fatigue. And then go to the gym. I think I'm gonna stop back at Sky Fitness today. I actually haven't been going there at all. I haven't gone there in a long time. I've been going to the X gym, like you know. But I think I'm going to go back to Sky, because I've been training early in the morning, first thing in the morning, and Sky is the closest to my house. It's really close to my house. So, just for convenience sake, and cutting down on travel time, I'm gonna go to Sky. Plus it's 24 hours, so you can go anytime. But go there first thing in the morning, and for the most, not every day, but for the most part, and go from there. All right, here we go. So here's the crazy thing. It is January 27th. That was the first time I've used a barbell the entire month of January. I've been doing exclusively dumbbell cable work. I needed a break. My joints needed a break. Need a mental break from just all the barbell work. I took like 2015 and 2016. I went really hard in focusing on gaining as much strength as possible. I mean, I was competing in powerlifting, and that was my goal. So, I mean, that's why I went all in, 100% focused on just getting as strong as possible, and very specific for barbell work. You know, the barbell bench press, barbell squat, deadlift. And I've taken the last few months, and in this month specifically, this entire month, to really just focus on going into the gym and feeling better leaving the gym than I do coming into the gym. And restoring some balance and working on some things, working on some imbalances, just trying to feel good again. And not that I was like overly beat up, I really wasn't. It was more mental than anything, just a lot of shit going on and just being super busy and just putting training on the back burner a little bit. But felt good to get back in and grab the barbell. I was excited to get back into Sky Fitness. It's been a while since I've been at this gym. I do like it. It's a nice gym, has everything I need. All right, I gotta get home. Got some more work to do. It's 5:30 p.m. Go get some food. All right, see you later. Early morning, gonna get a lift in. Gotta get my belt from my other car. There it is. Ah, belt fell over. Cool. I have it synced up to where I can listen to podcasts on here. Ooh, the Absolute Strength podcast. Barbell Business. Wonder why that episode came up. I don't even know how to use this yet. There we go.
It's a martial arts.
This is what I was listening to.
It's this. This is it.
Travis Mash had Zach Evanesh on his podcast.
She figures a way to overcome
it. That's what I was listening to on a walk down here. And I wanted to get it synced up on the car so I could listen to it on the way to the gym. Saturday morning, I'm at the gym. Gonna get some squats and some deadlifts. And then, I don't know really what else besides that. It's really all I have planned for the day. Today's Saturday, I'm gonna take tomorrow off Sunday. And then Monday, get my shit together and get back on a normal routine. And really go from there.
So there's no one even here. There's a couple people over doing cardio, but all the whole gym to myself. This should be good.
About 9 o'clock, finished my workout, got a solid 2 hour workout in. It's a good workout. I did a nice long warm up, which I showed some of. Warmed up good, front squats felt good, moved on to deadlifts. Deadlifts felt like shit, to be honest with you. I warmed up to like 405, and the entire warm up process, it's like, this is not feeling good. And then finally I got up to like 405, and I'm like, all right, I'm just gonna shut it down and be smart and not deadlift today. And I was kind of like frustrated with myself. I was like, man, why do these feel so bad? But then I'm like, you know what? Well, like I said earlier in the video, I hadn't touched a barbell in over a month, and I haven't deadlifted in probably a month and a half. So with all that being said, front squatting, you know, relatively heavy today for the first time in over a month, I think just fatigued my lower back, and I just couldn't get into a good position and just didn't feel good. So I'm like, screw it, move on. Did some lunges, did some leg curls, some chest supported rows, and then a little bit of core work, just a little quick core circuit, and felt pretty good. I am gonna go home now. Hopefully Lucy's up and we'll eat breakfast together. We always eat breakfast together, so. All right, time to go home. These are the two coffees I'm drinking right now. The Trader Joe's Dark Roast and Kicking Horse. This is really good coffee. I was surprised at how good
this is the Kicking Horse Smart Ass Blend. It's like a medium roast. Really good. I'm gonna have Trader Joe's today though. You ready for your oatmeal? There it is, it's done.